really take care to manage that we have so many students in the classroom. The teacher can take care of all the students. So there's inclusive program whereby the needs are met through proper lesson planning, different technique. You know, it's not, you know, like what I'm doing now, right? Which is the lecture is everybody sit quiet, take a note, quiet, then they take the test, it's over with. Okay, it's learning is developed greatly, you know, since I was in a classroom. I taught for over 20 years and then went into administration, and I had the fortunate luck to be principal of two schools before coming here to work with Rachel. The experience in Catholic education has changed, and all for the better. Because the more that we are more what the founder expects, the better it is going to be for our children. And they will see that, and then they are going to be the next generation that will make things grow. And the only way we can do that is always having him in the mind. And so that's very crucial. So yes, we are particular until we hire, that if it's very important that they are of that mindset, so that we know that not just in the religion class or theology class, but throughout the subject areas. Everything is taught with Christ in mind, and the students being the recipient of what he wants for children today. So that's our admissions piece, basically. So preschool all the way up to grade 12, that's always in mind. So there are screenings, there's all kind of testing being done in order to really help. And I think that's a unique thing that you find. And as you study about Catholic education, you'll probably see that it may not be the case across the board, which is, you know, it's slow. It's a slow process. The best part is that the downtown office, the Office of Catholic Schools, is on board with that. And that's very important. And that's only happened in the last, I don't know, maybe 7 to 10 years. Okay? The other piece, which is the money piece, okay, that's very important. And we cannot forget that in order to be fair and be moving forward, the money piece has got to be taken care of well. And so, yes, we do not want to be a business, by no means. But we have to collect the tuition, we have to be fair, we have to take care of financial aid, and we have to not set up people for failure. And in the past, a lot of schools, and in some of my own, where I was principal, that was part of the failure, is that that piece was maybe put to the side and then became a something that came to bite you in the pants later, okay? That came, you know, that was not good. So the tuition aspect, so we've been doing much better in recent, because we don't set up people for failure. So, for example, you come and you bring in a child, and you have one, and you pay full, okay? You come and you say, well, I really can't. So we have a financial aid process whereby we look at your adjusted gross income from your last income tax. We talk, we hear the story, we see what it is. The policy, and this is a tough one to follow, because the other high schools don't, but we don't go beyond 50% in assistance, which is an oddity. A lot of places go beyond, because they know that they can't. But the thing is that if you can't take care of half the bill, how are you going to take care of when your son comes and says, I need the new gym shoes for the gym class, I gotta have my uniform, I gotta get books, but then I need the bus pass, and then I need my lunch, and on Friday I wanna go to the movie, you know, too, and you know, I could use $10 to put, what, 2 gallons of gas in the car? How can you make it all work, right? We have to be honest. So when we look at the financial aid picture, it's not just based on the paper. You know, when you come and look at the tuition, I mean the income tax. So we don't outsource anymore. Most schools outsource their financial aid because they want to be fair. We do it here in-house because why make you pay, I think it's $30 now. They want to make you pay $30 to send your papers to Ohio to have somebody tell me that I got to make the decision in the end anyway. Right? Why spend your $30? Use the $30. You might get a third of a gallon, third of a tank of gas for that. Okay? So so that's part of also the process that we take care of with admissions. Luckily, we use an outside company, which is the norm now to do. Most Catholic schools use an outside company to collect, which is basically automatic debit out of your bank account. Once a month, 11 times out of the year, you get a break, you know, once a year, no tuition, pull, and we do that. And it's worked for us very well. We have options, obviously, for payment plans and things. Our families that struggle, we work with that. It's not too bad. We have about a 2%, 1.5% delinquency at the end of the year. You know, so when you're trying to collect $6 million, right? we run a $6 million operation here on the whole block, if you can imagine. Okay, that's a little staggering for me. Luckily, I have Miss Oliver who helps me out in my office. In terms of the other piece, it's what we're doing today. We're sharing with you. We're making you see what St. Benedict is all about, so that when you leave here, you say, my cousin's got a kid, and they did it. You know, maybe this is a good place for her, right? Because you've come to hear and feel good about Catholic education at Irving and Levitt, okay? And that's part of it. So our website has to show all the different things we do. You know, we have to. It's not about showing a pretty face. It's about all this involved. And just by looking at this room, you probably could see some things about what we're all about. Obviously the religious aspect, but more so that the teacher looks to using art. So it's creativity is in classrooms. Then we're not just focused on ourselves. The world is big, right? So you see. Because we're learning about others. We have to, okay? Then, justice is important to us. And you can see Archbishop Romero, you can see some of the poster and things. We, you know, certain things are very important. And you see, tolerance, you know? These are things that at one point were not something too, right, too important in our schools, but now are of major importance, okay? In the end, you know, the tradition, you know, you can see that we have our tradition, okay? We must be open to vocation. We must be connected with the rest of the world and how we deal with our brothers and sisters in poverty in other parts of the world. So, a lot speaks, you know, and so our website, and that must promote the same thing. And so you should be able to go and find the phone number. Right? And find the tuition rate. We also see about what we're all about. What we're all about. So doing that is very important. So I have a young lady who takes care of communications pretty much with in my office. And so that's a very important piece that can't be dropped. Okay? People say, well, you know, is it really that important? Yes. Because if we don't communicate well, we're not teaching our children to communicate well. And that's half of the battle, right? In terms of peace in the world, you know, diplomacy, you name it, all the way down to when you're sitting in front of your, you know, getting interviewed for a job. You know, you have to communicate well. So that's the other piece in my office. One other thing we have is I have a new gentleman that started, and he takes care of alumni relation. We don't want to forget the past, mainly because we have to maintain relation, but it's also because they're going to be there to help. They came to school here like you. You know, we're all, right? We're all older, right? Less hair, you know, a little wrinkle, okay? But we're all older. We all sat behind a desk. No matter what country in the world, maybe it wasn't a pretty desk. It might have been a bench and a thing. But, you know, they had a chalkboard instead of a whiteboard, you know. But we all were with a book in front of us. And we all learned. And we all appreciated somebody along the way helping us to learn. So alumni relations is very important because, you know, We have to engage them because people want to give back. And that's what we teach. You know,